Live. We are live. We are live. Hello, hello, and welcome to 30 Questions. Yes, late OP. We know we are late. It happens, okay? Last time we were early and nobody cared. Shreya is here with us. Hi, Shreya Dhanvantri, aka Sucheta Dalal from Scam 1992. And
Hello, friends.
hello, hello. Prateek will be here unless he has scammed us, as people in the audience are saying, and he will not be coming. How's it going, Shreya? Not going to count that as the first question, but how's it going? How's life post Scam 1992? Congratulations, first of all, on an incredible show.
Thank you. Thank you.
How is life? You were telling us about the thrilling things that are going on in your life.
Yeah, life has frustratingly been very, very normal. I'm waiting. I'm still waiting because I've been talking about this man for a week now in several other interviews. So he's become a very important part of my life. I'm still waiting for the plumber to come to my house and sort out the water issue, but
Just to
life has
see
been
real
so.
grounded actors, you know what I'm saying? Like plumbing issues and this and that. There's a
We like to
nobility
live
to the struggle.
amongst the real people to
Yeah,
keep ourselves down to earth
there's
and
a
stuff. So yeah,
nobility to the
it's a
struggle.
part. Yeah,
No,
it's
no.
a part of our education
No
in
matter
this country.
no matter how hit your show is, you'll never be too far from Aram Nagar, is what the universe is teaching
Ouch.
you. No, this is, see, you have to admit, Bombay keeps you in perspective, right? Bombay is a city that always keeps you in perspective. Like, you can fly very high, but someone, something will manage to keep you in perspective. Like, always. This is the thing you have to
Yeah,
appreciate about this city.
आई थिंक अंबानी के घर में भी होता होगा प्रॉब्लम. मतलब ही में नॉट लाइक हो, कभी तो होता होगा. लाइक इट्स इन बॉम्बे, दैट इज
नहीं,
वन
आई मीन
एक्सटर्नल
ओकेजनली
सप्लायर.
दे गो आउट टू देयर बालकनी एंड लुक डाउन, सो मिल जाता है
हाँ, लाइक
पर्सपेक्टिव.
आई एम श्योर, नो, आई एम श्योर देयर सम गाइस दैट सेंड ड्रोन्स अप देयर. लाइक सम बॉम्बे गाइस लाइक देखते हैं एंटीला के बालकनी में क्या होता है इन समबडी सेंस.
I
एंड द
have been
यंगर,
inside the house, by the way. Fun
ओ
fact.
रियली,
You
व्हाट्स इट
what?
लाइक?
You've been to the house. Please tell us
Yeah. The
what's the coolest thing about Antil. Tell us.
cool. Okay, I actually have several stories about this. I'm wondering how much trouble I voluntarily want to get into. So they have floor managers
Like on, like
Okay.
how you have on a set.
For every floor, they have a person who handles the floor.
Oh
And each floor
man.
has its designated purpose. Like one floor, when I had gone there, Abu Jani and Sandeep Khosla, back when I was modeling, they invited the 50 top models of the country. Please don't ask me why they called me. To inaugurate like some 10 years of being in the industry.
Okay.
So they had converted their paintball floor for hair and makeup.
There stood one, so they had a paintball floor.
What floor?
Second of all,
Exactly.
that
There are
they converted
several
that.
layers in this piece of information.
That
And
is.
no, it gets better. Yeah, Rohan, listen. Then we were feeling chilly because obviously it's been 10 years and the clothes haven't elongated to cover all parts of the body. So we were wearing very, very little to no garment. And so we were feeling very chilly. So we went to the floor manager and we requested her to please kindly raise the temperature. And she said, not kidding you, she said, sorry, ma'am, the temperature has to be maintained at this level for the flowers and the marble.
What
Wow.
absurdly delicate marble is this that will
Also,
melt? That will
no,
melt?
the flowers are flown in from like Amsterdam, if I'm not wrong. I think I asked.
Those are not flowers.
Those are not flowers.
Not
They're
flowers.
herbs. Those are not flowers. They're herbs.
Yeah, I don't know
There's a
any partake in
difference.
that particular
No,
So this
fuck
was my
that.
very surreal experience in that.
I just like this औकात of like तू फ्लावर से कम इंपॉर्टेंट है, तू मार्बल से कम, जो जमीन पे मार्बल तू उससे कम. मैन
नहीं,
दिस गोज बैक टू
आई
व्हाट रोहन वाज टॉकिंग अबाउट, पर्सपेक्टिव.
एम बॉम्बे कीप्स यू ग्राउंडेड. सी
या
ऑल्सो व्हाट आई एम स्टिल डीलिंग विद द फैक्ट दैट देर आर फ्लोर मैनेजर्स. ऑल राइट, मेरे बिल्डिंग का एक वॉचमैन है जो ऑलरेडी सो गया. फ्लोर तो छोड़ो,
सेम सेम सेम.
बिल्डिंग का एक सिक्योरिटी गार्ड है जो ऑलरेडी
ऑल्सो
सो गया.
हाउ आर यू ऑल मिसिंग द फैक्ट लाइक आई कांट गेट दिस विजुअल ऑफ माई हेड वेर नीता सॉरी या नीता एंड मुकेश आर प्लेइंग पेंटबॉल विद ईच अदर. लाइक दैट टू मी इज अ हिलेरियस विजुअल. आई डोंट
Yeah,
केयर
I
इफ इट्स
don't
नॉट
think
ट्रू.
they are. It's for their kids and their
प्लीज,
friends.
no, प्लीज,
दैट्स, आई
you
मीन, यू
never
नेवर
know.
नो, यू नेवर नो. मे बी दैट्स हाउ दे वर्क थ्रू द ट्रबल्स इन द मैरिज. लाइक हाउ डू यू नो? इट्स जस्ट गो एंड लाइक इंटेंस पेंटबॉल ईच
Hey,
अदर.
why not? Yeah, it's a very healthy
या
bonding exercise.
आई
या
अग्री, आई
एग्जैक्टली.
अग्री,
It's the
आई
opposite.
कंप्लीटली अग्री. आई एम
And
गोना,
funnily enough, the whole time they told me that, I was very aware that I had never played paintball in my life. How sad is that?
Even I've never played paintball in my life. It's
Yeah,
okay, I
same.
sympathize.
I
See,
wanna, yeah. It really seems like a lot of fun.
but also apparently it hurts a
Very
lot.
painful. Yeah. I see my friends
Yeah,
with like bruises that last like
exactly
3 weeks.
all this.
Because I want those bruises and that pain. I want to experience it.
I don't know. It looks damn cute and all, and then it just looks like chata lagta hai. Matlab, it really looks.
We've always planned to go, right? Remember, there's one in Pavai, or there used to be one in Pavai.
Yeah. We've always planned to go, and then realize it's too much activity for us, basically.
Yeah. Then we found a bar near the house. So we're like,
this is always this thing. I'm going to start because with questions from our chat. Our chat is already bursting with questions. Which is, I'll start with question number one, which is from, let me scroll up. This is a very professional stream, as you can see. Ankita Jain has a question, which is actually an interesting question. What's one trait of Harshad Mehta that everybody here actually liked, but would never want to emulate?
What do you call it when, you know, someone, like, apart from crime, when somebody tries to push the line to see how far they can go? What do you, is there an adjective for that quality? Because that's quite admirable.
Like, is it the apart same as pioneering? Is it the same as pioneering?
Why not? Why not? Pioneering. I like that quality.
Yeah,
exploration.
He did that though. He was like, hey, look, explicitly yahan kahi nahi nahi likha hai. So, jab problem aayega to dekhenge.
Kisi ne crime imagine hi nahi kiya tha na ki aisa kar sakte hain. Right? It was beyond our socialist imagination at that point.
True.
So imagination. Let's call it a sweet childlike imagination. I like it. I like that.
It's true.
But for me, it's and I guess, I don't know if this is a good word or a bad word, but it's, there was a casual cockiness to him. And as somebody who is severely underconfident in their life, I am programmed to be jealous of confident people. Like, I'm just like, how? Like, the audacity, right? Like, because he just, like, the guy at one point was just like, you know what? Main jaake RBI governor ko samjhata. Like, that's the audacity of that.
Yeah, just, I'm just jealous that he was able to sleep at night. Like, how? I would...
Ashish went deep, man.
No. Like, from a physical, not from a moral point of view, just from a physical, like, I would be so stressed out if I was doing all that shit. Like, there's no way I would be able to...
Hence the casual cockiness. I think that's what Rohan meant.
Yeah. That it was crazy. Just like, yeah, come. Yeah, okay, IT raid is coming. I've cooked breakfast for y'all. Come. Like,
yeah, come.
Like,
yeah.
Ye swag hota hai na. Like, this is called proper swag.
Did you see that interview where he actually says, apart from a couple of crores, I don't need much. And I'm like, bro, same.
Yeah, same.
Same.
But you have to define what that couple is. What is that couple of crore? Is it 200? Is it 300? Is it 400? Next question. Where do you think this TV series stands in relation to stories like Wolf of Wall Street or The Big Short? Also, is glorification a necessary thing for driving the plot ahead? Mr. Pink from Reservoir Dogs wants to know.
Okay. Actually, our writers had Margin Call in mind, not the other two films
we were
talking about. So, if you have seen that, I feel like there are a lot more, you know, it's more tech heavy, it's more finance heavy. And almost everybody is speaking crap that you don't understand. Hmm. Half the characters are speaking in English and they're speaking very fast. So, it's a lot of information in very little time.
Yes.
So, I think there's a lot more similarity to Margin Call in that sense. And surprisingly, not a lot of spoon feeding, which I'm very proud of.
There is not a lot of spoon feeding. Yeah. I actually remember having to pause multiple. Ek to I'm the world's most nastic gujju, acha. Because stock market ke baare mein ghanta pata hai. Like, ghanta pata hai. And there was just this point at which I had to pause and be like, 1 second. What is shorting? What is going long? What the fuck is happening here? But
no, because I remember because the script is this big, I'm not kidding you. You can like, it's proper.
It is a very verbose show. It is a very verbose show. So
No, and it's 550 pages. So it's almost like a murder weapon. It's really thick. And when I read the script, like I could get the bare bones of the story, right? Because I didn't understand, because it was so technical and I didn't understand, well, most of it because it was so technical. So I remember when Hansel and Jay asked me, so how's the show? I'm like, acha hai?
very realistic.
Yeah,
in BA economics, kya kar raha hai?
So it starts like a statement, ends like a question. I'm like, acha hai? And let me get back to you. So I went and actually took tuition from my dad for this show.
That was going to be my follow-up question. Did you have to do like a crash course? Because when you're on screen, like from the first time we meet you, your first scene is very like, Ah, security bank, SBL, BR.
Like,
SC, there we go. All this, right? Yeah, SGL, yeah. BR. Like, you're rattling it off. And I was like, was there a crash course involved? Like,
yeah, man. So my dad is actually a finance and revenue director. So finally, when he, when I asked him and I explained the story and I told him that this is what I'm doing and I'm playing Sucheta Dalal, who wrote the book and the show is based on her book. My dad's like, oh, finally, I'll watch something you're in. So that was pretty cool. And then I had to take like 3-hour session classes for like 10 days.
Oh,
and
wow.
I still understood maybe like 10-20% of it.
I mean, you that understood enough to just say SGL. Like,
I mean, I should know what I'm talking about, right? It shouldn't look like I've just like learned it by heart.
Yeah, of course.
But
of course.
But most actors kind of just learn it by heart, I imagine. I don't know. I feel like most actors just be like, haan, whatever.
But also, I think it depends on what you're working on, right? Like, in the sense, I'm guessing the guys who did, like, say, Margin Call, for example, at least had a basic understanding of what happened at Lehman Brothers versus when they show Hackers
like
in movies, right?
Or like Akshay Kumar and Mission Mangal or whatever. I don't think.
Right? Where it's that thing of I've de-stripped the USB kernel from the mainframe 64-bit hard drive and I've managed to loop the DJ set.
My favorite in films is... Wait, freeze that. Enhance.
Yeah!
Got it. That's my favorite.
144p ka suddenly 4K ho jata hai.
That's my favorite. But again, coming back to what you were saying, Ashish, I think it's a personal call. You want to understand what you're playing and what, I mean, if you want to be able to sell it truthfully, or you don't give a shit and say that, listen, I can sell trees in my sleep or whatever. So it's your personal thing. I don't know how much it affects your performance, honestly.
Harshad Bhai is here! Harshad Bhai is here! Harshad Bhai is here and connecting to audio. Harshad Bhai, aavi gaya. Everybody thought you were going to scam us today. It is so good to have you.
Hi, guys.
Hi. First of all, like we've already said to Shreya, I want to say congratulations on, I think, the show that has been the talk of the year and a tremendous, tremendous performance. And this is a genuinely exciting moment for me, not just because you're on my stream, but because I think it's very cool to talk to two people in a show that I have enjoyed so much this year. Like, this is my dream come true. So thank you so much for doing this.
Thank you.
And yeah, Shreya, you were saying, sorry to interrupt.
What was I saying? No, I just say it's a prerogative. Yeah. If you really want to be like that cool person who wants to know what they're doing before just spouting off lines. Right. So even Pratik had to know a lot of the stuff that he was talking about.
Oh, obviously.
Symbols. For short and like the number of stocks and the price, you're selling the specific symbols.
Correct.
And gestures.
What is this? What is this?
This is your cue. Jump in.
So this is selling. This is buying.
Okay.
Right. This is 15. This is 17.5. This can be 22. This can be 22, 25.5.
That circle thing.
This and this.
Some circle thing. Huh?
Yeah. And so this is 25. This is 25. This is 550, 500, 5,000.
Yeah.
This is 25.
You add a zero for a
this
circle.
This is 25,000. That you add a zero for a circle.
Right. Yeah. Okay.
And that's how these guys used to actually trade in the ring.
Correct. Because this is a thing that young people watching today might not understand this, but there was a time when people had to physically enter a ring to trade shares, and it was like an actual like WWE Royal Rumble. Young people today might not know what WWE Royal Rumble is. So
at least you call it WWE and not WWF.
Which is everybody's wondering why the pandas are fighting each other.
It was.
And then
Come from the time of WWF.
We are all from the time of WWF, so I assure you. Other
then
than
suddenly
Shreya,
we realize that it's all fake.
It's
not fake. What are you talking about? It's not fake. It's real.
My heart broke a little the first time. Like, significantly bigger moment in my life than finding out that Santa Claus is not real.
Yeah.
Oh, no. I found out. I mean, I was introduced to the concert by somebody telling me it was fake. So, it didn't feel.
Oh.
Oh, yeah. No. That's no fun. It's way more fun imagining.
Was that the same time when that cricket thing also came out?
The
scam of the cricket.
Oh, I think it
was
thode baad
tha.
Like, 96, 97.
99
was the
yeah 96 97.
वो तो बहुत बड़ा what are you saying cricket मतलब
और सबसे बड़ा और वो इंडिया साउथ अफ्रीका का सबसे बड़ा हार्टब्रेक
था. Okay, Shreya, don't say that.
That is twice. She's been like, I don't have any recollection of this.
Oh my God. Just trying to be young.
My heart broke because India had gotten its ass kicked by South Africa in the build-up to that series. I went for the Titan Cup final in which India beat South Africa, and then it turned out that was one of the rigged games. And my heart broke.
I have a question. With all these rigged games and match fixing, I remember very few people like Azharuddin and all these people getting like, you know, caught and stuff. I mean, for a sport game to be rigged, shouldn't everyone be in on it?
So their argument is that the actions of a few players are enough, few key players are enough to destabilize what the team is doing, as long as they're people. So which is why a lot of these people, at least in the 96-99, this thing, were top level. So it was Azharuddin, Hansi Kronje. They were going straight for captains, because even if the other people aren't rigging, the argument is that these guys can control who goes in and out. So yeah, you can hold back your good bowler. You can hold back your good batsman. You can do bad strategies, all of those things.
It's like legitimately possible.
It is legitimately possible.
A lot of people didn't know what was going on.
It's so possible that they flew Hansi Kronje into the side of a mountain to stop him from speaking
to people.
It's true. They did that. This is a fact. It's true. They did this.
I think many years have passed and we can joke about it.
It's been long enough. Right? Never forget. Never forget. Yeah. So, I have to ask Harshad Bhai this important question that Ankita Jain asked. Which is a trait of Harshad Mehta that you like, but will never ever want to have yourself in you?
Oh, the trait that I like, but I don't want to have.
Huh.
I guess his arrogance.
Yes.
Gave such a nice answer, no? We were just like goofing around. Prateek, you're making us look bad.
Yeah, please come down to our level, please.
Yeah, please,
Oh my God.
Giving all proper answers and stuff.
So I guess his pants, those style of pants that I like, but I can't wear it.
The 90s suits where everything had to be three sizes bigger than the person.
Thank you, Pratik.
Mr. Pink, this other question, Pratik, I was running to one or two questions that you missed. Where does this show stand in relation to stories like Wolf of Wall Street or Big Shot? Shreya mentioned that the writer would think of margin call. The interesting question here is glorification a necessary thing for driving the plot ahead? I want to preface it by saying that I personally didn't think the show glorified Harshad Mehta so much as just humanized him.
I was about to give you the same answer, that nowhere that we have tried to glorify anything or even to tell the story from one particular perspective.
Right.
Like Harshad as a hero or Harshad as a villain was also not the idea.
Hmm.
One human being taking some decisions in certain situations is what is, you know, driving him ahead. And that is taking him to the conclusion is what we have seen. And that's it. So glorification, I don't think that glorification was ever the idea.
Because this is a question that comes up a lot, especially now that we're seeing a lot of biopics and a lot of shows being made about some of the most flawed characters in history, right? This was a question that came up during, say, a Narcos also, right? Where it's like, what is the risk of trying to humanize a Pablo Escobar, for example? But I think, Pratik, it was you. I was reading an interview where you said that at the end of the day, and that was a very interesting statement. You said, if you're playing the guy, you can't play him as a villain or a hero. You have to play him as a guy who understands, or you have to empathize with the guy at least, right? Because from inside, he's not seeing himself as a hero or a villain. So I can't, which I thought was very cool as an approach.
Because what happens is that a lot of times in a lot of scenes whenever I perform, either it's in theater or film or wherever, sometimes I actually have to ask the director that what exactly did you want to communicate to the audience here?
Right.
And that's how I have to approach the character, right?
Right.
So here in Harshad's case, we were very clear that we don't want to communicate anything clearly to the audience. We want to keep it open for the audience's interpretation. That somebody amongst us did something like this. Now you decide.
Right.
How much of it was right, how much of it was wrong.
Right.
And this kind of real life character is what we see every day around us.
Correct.
That's the moral dilemma in what we are all living right now.
Right.
True. Nobody's 100% right, nobody's 100% wrong.
Yeah.
And that was the overall idea.
But what I don't like is people are calling me the goddamn villain.
Why?
What?
No. It's actually very interesting that you say that, Shreya. Because the thing is, I finished watching the show and then like everybody else, I immediately went on YouTube, real Harshad Mehta, real Sucheta Dalal, all of that. And the thing that struck me is that there is an entire category of people in the comments who maintain that Harshad Mehta was some sort of hero of the sort of guy who just exploited loopholes and found things, and he was some sort of essentially dark arts wizard to them, not a villain. And the narrative that they've built around him is this idea that India does not like to see somebody come up from nothing and succeed, and that's why the markets pulled him down, which to me is not the distinct, but there's a lot of people that, like, you're right, Shreya, a lot of people look at me like, Sucheta Dalal, the only person who got anything from this was Sucheta Dalal. And I'm like, that, what?
So, and they start making where is stupid coming from? Comments like, oh, I lied to my mother that I'm at the hospital, but I'm at my friend's house. Don't put a scam on me. It's not funny, guys. It's not funny.
Let it all out, Shreya. Let it all out. This is a safe space.
This is like, when in that Ambani story in Guru, the same debate happened, right? Like, we are in India. Ye system kuch karne nahi deta. Fir hum karenge kuch. And then Goenka comes in with the Indian Express. And he's like, nahi. And everyone's like, no. Guru Bhai is great. Harshad Mehta, a little more complicated, I imagine. A little more public money.
Yeah. Significantly more, right?
Little more.
Just a little bit. Just a little bit.
Yeah. In a lot of interviews, I was asked this question that what if Sucheta Dalal was not there? What would have happened to Harshad? And what is the answer? And the obvious answer is, I guess he must have been alive.
But I mean, it would have caught up with him eventually, right? Because the sense I got is that his appetite was not going anywhere.
Yeah. And at one point, it seems that he also got it. That now it's done. It's over.
Yeah, I think so.
But he was just putting up a strong face.
I guess, right? Because beyond a point, how do you undo such a big lie?
It is not possible.
You, beyond a point, can't.
Plus, he only had the one creative solution of like repaying someone by borrowing somewhere else. And he kept doing that again and again. It's the same trick, man, in the end.
Like, Shreya's so like, I need better magicians. same trick every time.
This is the game.
Can't do this.
You can't be a one-trick pony, man.
Fair, that's fair. To that end, Advait has a good question. It's your last job. If it were your last job, would you choose theatre or film? This is open-ended question to both of you. Ashish and I would choose sitting on couch and not being cast in anything.
These are the only two options.
You know what? Go ahead. Add another option. Go right ahead. It's your last acting job. Theater.
It's the last acting job for me.
Yeah. It's your last acting job. And then you, what do you choose?
Film?
Yeah. We got film. We got theater.
Terminator 2 Judgment Day spoiled me for life. It's my first love. I'll never.
That'll do it. Like, that'll do it.
Ever.
That's it. That is it. Yeah. That's the first thing I ever saw on screen, and that's it. Love.
Terminator 2 is one of those movies where you see the special effects in it. You're like, how are there movies with special effects today that are worse than this?
How? Like, how are they doing the VFX RR, guys?
Yeah.
They're stealing their jobs, I mean,
yes. I don't know about you guys. I sit through the credits of all movies just to wait for that gigantic Indian section.
Just to see the Indian question.
Just to see the Indian
news. So answer to that question is like, how are the people bad at mathematics in this current digital era than the people who used to do mathematics without calculators? It is that same logic, man.
Fair. Wait, that makes sense.
How does that make sense?
But I mean, in the sense that there are more tools now to do the math for you. You're not required to do the math.
So that means you can
still
be so stupid at math.
Still, there are more goof-ups that you can do. Because, see, it's not only the actual mathematics that you do with the tools. It's the logic behind it. So as of now, the overall understanding is that there is technology for everything. I don't need to learn and, go into detail. I just have to have basics known to me and then I can manage anything.
There's a proper evolution for stupidity, man. We'll only get stupider.
I just want to do a 1 minute silence for all the kids in the audience who thought they'll come here for acting ka advice milega. Pratik will be like, follow your heart. And Pratik is like, Maths siko! Maths nahi aata siko!
Sorry.
Okay. So I just got an engineer with me today. I'll just call the actor. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Cool.
No, but serious question. Oh,
Pratik's friend who looks just like Pratik. That's amazing. Point,
I mean, have you all
wait, is everyone on this an engineer?
I'm a 1/4 of an engineer.
I know about Rohan. Ashish?
I have a degree, yeah.
All three. Then. Yeah. Three and a half.
Oh my God. I have a diploma plus degree.
So I have a degree. It's not in engineering.
Yeah. So me and Rohan will create two engineers actually.
Yeah, right there. Right there. I'm with this guy.
What do you all study?
EC.
Oh, same. EC only. Electronics and Telecom.
Diploma Mechanical B Production. I'm an industry
engineer. My God. You did. You went hardcore lathe machine shop. Oh, my God.
Yeah, man.
Between the three of you, we could build a tank. Between me, I could paint the tank. Like,
buddy.
Oh, my God.
Do a live stream of the tank being built.
Ooh. These two can maybe build something. Yeah. These two can build something. You can live stream. I can do jokes. That's the only thing I know.
Yeah. Pratik and I will gladly take that. Gladly.
Some jokes can kill.
As a comedian in India, I know.
We know this. We are very aware of this. Pratik, to continue the same thing that sort of Shreya said, since you saw his theater, how Terminator 2 was her moment? What was sort of your moment or play where you were like, I want to do this. This is what I want to do for my whole life.
I don't remember any such moment where I decided to do this, because I guess I stepped on the stage at a very early age when I was in third, fourth standard. So ever since then, I always felt that stage is the place where I always wanted to be.
Beautiful.
You know,
for
be
me, it's
theater,
literally, I stepped onto stage because I saw Terminator 2.
Oh,
wow. That's cool.
Sorry. Continue, Pratik. Sorry.
Yeah. Nah, so that's what I was saying, that there is no particular moment or incident that I think where I decided to be an actor or to go on stage, because it was always there, you know. Woh aisa age tha ki jab mujhe pata hi nahi tha ki what is it like to be on stage and to act.
And these
but
were...
I always, yeah.
Can I show off about Pratik a little bit?
Yes, please.
So Pratik did a monologue, okay, a 2-hour monologue.
I
as
know
Mahatma Gandhi,
yes,
in three languages, and he's a Limca Book of Records holder because of that.
What
the hell? I almost want to like remove you from this stream. Like, it's just not allowed. Like, are you
in three languages?
Please tell
on
us.
The same day, 2 hours.
Please tell us more about this.
Yeah. So this is called Mohan's Masala is the play's name, the name of the play, and it's a monologue of 2 hours. It is about young Mohandas Gandhi,
right?
Who comes on stage and he starts talking that bloody everybody talks about Mahatma and father of the nation. Nobody talks about me. I was the one who made your Mahatma. And I was never a born Mahatma. I'm just a common man like you. You know, I had my dreams. I did a lot of goof ups and then his journey. So that I perform in Hindi, English and Gujarati.
On the same day.
Each. Yeah. So morning 11 o'clock, we had Gujarati show at Prithvi. Then 4 o'clock Hindi and 7:30 English.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
Wow. Pratik OP in chat, please. That is wild. That is wild. Any more casual flexes? Any more casual flexes?
I flex for him.
You flex for him. It's true. It's true. You're his hype moment.
He's being damn modest, dude.
Yeah,
no, this is our routine and everything. I have to talk about it because he won't talk about it.
Correct.
Yeah, because
any Shreya accomplishments that she doesn't talk about that you want to discuss?
He only talks about me eating food, yeah.
No. So Shreya has lot of things that I think I'm too small
you are
person
on
this. हाँ मतलब मुझे पूरा या तो monologue करना पड़ेगा Shreya पे.
मतलब ये स्ट्रीम वैसे 2 घंटा चल सकता है. पिक अ लैंग्वेज एंड गो फॉर इट. इट्स फाइन.
ओह माय गॉड. हां सो बियॉन्ड अ पॉइंट आई शुड गिव दैट ऑप्शन. पिक अ लैंग्वेज एंड देन आई
स्टार्ट. या पिक अ लैंग्वेज एंड गो फॉर इट. लाइक इट्स नो प्रॉब्लम एट ऑल.
बट श्रेया के लिए मैं वो उनकी नेटिव लैंग्वेज भी सीख रहा हूं. आई जस्ट कमेंटेड ऑन श्रेयाज वन ऑफ द कमेंट्स
सेइंग
इन तेलुगु.
क्या या इन तेलुगु?
नाउ आई लर्निंग तेलुगु आल्सो.
यू सेड समथिंग. आई एम ट्राइंग टू लर्न दो
कितने लोगों का जॉब लोगे आप सर?
बट रोहन दिस इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग. व्हेन आई परफॉर्म्ड दिस थ्री लैंग्वेजेस इन वन डे, व्हाट I've understood and learned is that each and every language has a different grammar when it comes to, you know, writing the language, speaking the language.
Yes.
But it has a different grammar of performance also.
Right. I know what you mean.
So the meter of the sentence will change. Your pause work will change.
Absolutely.
The way you have to create the character is changing. That is so interesting.
That is absolutely, you're right. And that's something that a lot of people don't think about. And you see that also with a lot of actors, because sometimes you know that they have a natural base language in their head and they are just translating. But they're translating using the meter of their base language. Right. And so it doesn't, like, you can't do an English sentence, translate it into Hindi in your head and speak it out, because your pauses will be for the English. Right.
So your punch or your joke will never land if you do that.
Yeah.
But that's what they say about learning a language, right? If you're truly able to be funny in that language, that means you've learned it properly.
So according to most people who watch my channel, mere ko to English bhi nahi aata. If you believe the comments. Okay, let's go to a nice light and easy question. Ketan wants to know, what is your opinion on favoritism in Bollywood?
Oh my God.
Lot of opinions.
Expound forth.
पब्लिक को कितना मजा आता है ना ये सवाल पूछने में.
I was just talking to somebody. He said favoritism कहाँ नहीं है यार, घर पे भी तो होता है. छोटे भाई बड़े भाई के बीच में मम्मी पापा नहीं करते हैं क्या कि ये मेरा लाडला, ये मेरा. ले मामा के घर जाओगे तो एक बच्चे को ज्यादा, एक किला ज्यादा दे देंगे, तू रख, किसी को बोलना मत. तो बोले यार फेवरेटिज्म, आई गेस इट्स देयर, आई मीन यू लाइक समथिंग मोर एंड समथिंग लेस एंड दैट्स ओके, इट्स वेरी ह्यूमन.
फेयर फेयर फेयर.
आई वेल बिकॉज आई थिंक दिस प्लेस वाज आर्ट प्राइमरली स्टार्टेड एज अ वे टू लाइक स्टिक इट टू द मैन एंड समहाउ इन द प्रोसेस बिकेम द मैन, which I find very interesting. And like, what pisses me off, this really, this is something I wish would change. It's not that I'm denying that, because things like nepotism, things like favoritism, we are a legacy-based nation. We are a legacy-based people, dynasty, you know, based people. So we tend to think of everything and we tend to keep everybody in those sort of spaces, right? We don't like bloodlines so much. We like everybody to stay in their lanes.
True.
It's just in my particular, because I faced this personally, the at least the very right to fight for an opportunity should be equal to all, at least.
This is fair and this is true. I agree. This is true.
That's
like the process, the entry process should be fair at the very least.
That's all. Just the right to fight for the opportunity. That's it.
Fair.
It shouldn't be like a one-off situation where the star or whatever famous person with a whatever famous last name or a connection says, I had to audition for this. Come
and
on,
yeah, what a huge deal. Like, yeah.
Yeah, have some shame, yeah.
Like, really?
So I agree to what she said, but at the same time, I have a little, just a different opinion or just a different take on it. That sometimes I really feel that those who are so-called privileged or insiders or whatever that we call, I really feel sad about them. Why? Because that they could never get that opportunity, those opportunities that we had to explore ourselves in all the possible formats.
Fair.
There are a lot of people who could never even go for an audition.
Yeah, fair.
Even if they wanted. Mm. And because I'm saying this because of the experience that after having multiple failed auditions, I have learned a lot of things, which I guess nobody can teach you.
Yeah, fair. That's
anyway.
True.
तो ये एक्सपीरियंस ही नहीं मिला उनको. मुझे तो दया आती है उन पे के बेचारे यार, मतलब तुम रह गए.
लीव इट टू प्रतीक टू मेक पॉवर्टी एंड रिस्क एंड बैड लक साउंड लाइक समथिंग गुड.
राइट, यू हैव टू रोमांटिसाइज द स्ट्रगल, राइट? लाइक यू हैव टू रोमांटिसाइज द स्ट्रगल टू रैशनलाइज द पेन ऑफ इट, राइट?
एंड यू हैव टू डू इट वंस यू हिट अ सर्टेन, लाइक यू डू इट व्हाइल यू आर गोइंग थ्रू इट, इट कीप्स यू सेन. एंड वंस यू आर डन, यू आर लाइक अरे इसमें क्या, ये तो
इंपॉर्टेंट.
या इट्स लाइक यू आस्क समबडी.
या
But it's like, I know it sounds like you asking somebody who's just cleared 10th 2 years back and kya dasme mein kya yaar usme thodi koi fail hota hai yaar, but jo uski exam dene ja raha hai uski band baji padi hai.
Yeah.
I know.
that is true. And I think also what happens sometimes privileged people is, and I think privileged people are more likely to give up when the situation is not to their this thing than somebody who has genuinely struggled, because if you've never faced adversity, your chances of just sort of being like, this is not worth my time and walking away from what is a wonderful opportunity also are possible.
Okay, but then I have a counter question. But for people who've never faced adversity or actually never having to, never, it's not required of them, do they ever end up actually ever facing it during their lifetime?
Yes and no, in a sense.
As well?
I guess they are, but I feel like a lot of those people are also then shielded from true greatness.
For sure.
Right?
No, I would disagree.
It's their loss, no. I feel it's their loss here.
Yeah, but here's the thing, right? Like everyone's, like you don't compare suffering because it doesn't work that way in the sense that a privileged person's struggle for them is the max struggle and pain they faced. And objectively, it is less than anybody else's, but to them, it is their world. So, so they will never feel like maine struggle nahi kiya, no matter how much.
Nobody will feel that. You're right.
Yeah. Their struggle is different. Their definition of struggle is different.
Which is why there is conflict.
Starting point may be different.
No, it's like what Prateek said, right? Everybody is the hero in their own life.
Correct.
No, I think Siddhant Chaturvedi had once said a very interesting thing in that actors roundtable with a bunch of people where, like, बहुत फनी था बिकॉज लाइक जहां इनका मतलब इनका स्ट्रगल जहां खत्म होता है हमारे सपने वहां शुरू होते हैं लाइक इज व्हाट ही सेड लाइक लिटरली
जहां हमारे सपने पूरे होते हैं
उनकी हाँ उनकी स्ट्रगल वहां शुरू होती है
उस पे वो टिकटॉक वाला ओ गाना करके
बिफोर वी मूव फॉरवर्ड जस्ट रियली क्विकली गोना गो थ्रू सम सुपर चैट्स शिवांशु शुक्ला हैज सेड आई हैव स्टार्टेड ट्रेडिंग आफ्टर वाचिंग 1992 स्कैम शिवांशु यू टुक द रॉन्ग लेसन्स फ्रॉम द शो
I started going swimming after watching Jaws. Like,
no, but a lot of people have, na, Pradeep? A lot of people have told us this, that a lot of people have been a lot of people.
Yeah, I'm sure. I've considered it. But still
they got intrigued by this world of stocks. Yeah,
understandable.
Even in death, Harshad Mehta causing some losses.
So somebody, somewhere.
By the way, can we take a small sidebar to just notice how nice Prateek looks?
Yeah.
Prateek, you look very nice, yeah.
Amazing.
Is it?
Yeah.
It's true. why does that make you shy? It's true. Piyush Pandey, thank you for your super chat. Said Scam has set up a new standard for Indian OTT shows. Loved performances of all the folks. My question is, what are some of the bad OTT shows you came across? No, we're not going to badmouth any shows on this chat. Everybody tries. Everybody makes an effort. Shivanshu, do you know Shivanshu has flexed here? You know how he sent a super chat, which is a paid chat, thing that I started investing after watching Scam 1992. And now we said this. Shivanshu has sent more money saying, I've made money also. On the market. Yeah, Shivanshu so ka good, swag.
Man.
Shivanshu,
Shivanshu, man.
Yeah, well done, Shivanshu.
Share some tips with us.
Yeah, please share some. Actually, Karan Chawla is the next question, which is, have you invested in stocks?
Not yet.
I'm waiting for Shivanshu to ask Prateek and Shreya about. यारे लक्ष्मी विलास बैंक के साथ क्या चल रहा है आजकल यार? कुछ शोर नहीं है यार. उसपे क्या SGL का सीन है कि BR का सीन है?
मतलब ये moratorium क्यों हो रहा है? Hardik is asking me, how does it feel to redirect 13,000 hits to Sony Live while only getting 125 viewers on your stream? You know what, man? It means more people watch this show. It's worth it. It is totally worth it.
That's a lot of detail research put into one comment.
That is.
Data is new gold, man.
Suman Sajnani has a question, which I'm 100% sure that you guys will have an answer to being actors. My dad wants me to ask about the 1 crore Harshad Mehta gave to Narasimha Rao. What does the cast know about this?
Yeah,
well,
we
my
knew
dad
about
actually
it.
Said
that's how
it's
we filmed
a huge
it.
Deal. It was a huge deal when it actually happened and it was in the news. And he did get, I think there were inquiries made into that. I'm not sure if he got fined for it. But did he get fined for it?
Yeah, there were a lot.
Was he asked to resign?
A lot of things happened, but I am not sure about the final result.
Yeah, I'm also not sure about the final result that happened. Wow, Shivanshu has sent one more super chat saying, my tip is buy low, sell high. Thank you, Shivanshu.
Wow.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you.
Ye CID ki tarah case solve kar diya.
Haan, exactly. Sir, ye to stock hai.
Sir, ring baj rahi hai. Lagta hai kisi ka phone hai.
Lots of people sending in love for both of you. Blog Therapy says my crush Shreya. Mr. Pink also says that. This is a chat from earlier because Amit is saying Prateek bhai kahan hai. Okay, Prateek bhai yahan hai. Prateek bhai yahan hai. Somebody has just Shreya has responded just saying guys they have small Switzerland in Antilla. Now you know this thing. Prajakta actually is an interesting question. Don't need a political stand on this, but what is your take on the potential regulation and censorship that might now apply to OTT content?
I'm dreading it. I'm curious to see what they will sort of clamp down on and what they will allow pass. I'm curious to see. Yeah. Wary, but curious.
I am very curious to know what are they trying to censor. I mean, what are they trying to search out of it?
Yeah.
It's like if, like I had said in one of the interviews, that if we need more sensors at traffic signals in our vehicles to avoid accidents. So that's the area where we are actually looking at the sensors.
Yes, absolutely.
But this sensor, I don't know how far it's going to change the world.
I don't know. I don't, because it just feels like to me as a viewer, right? I mean, you guys as actors, so it must be like a different liberation only. But to me as a viewer, dude, the late 90s and the 2000s were like the dark ages of content, right? Because everything had been taken over by these daily soaps, and it was like imagination had gone to die. So this OTT thing, like, I still remember there was this moment where, you remember the first time you saw that first episode of Sacred Games? Like, yeah. And you just sort of had this moment of, kisi ne acha camera aur light use kiya aaj.
Yeah.
Like, ye pehli baar dekha hai. And then you've just seen things go up and up and up, and it's been beautiful.
Dude, that moment where you go from, it's good for India, to just plain, it's good.
It's good.
Like, I love that transition that it happened, and it happened in the last few years.
That's actually, and also actually, now that you got, I have a tangential question to this, that a lot of my friends, because I've been asking friends around the world to watch the show, where can they watch the show in different parts of the world? Is it available internationally?
Yeah, so US, I guess in US, Sony has tied up with Sling TV, something called Sling TV.
Okay.
Where they can get this kind of membership and they can watch it.
Okay, so American people, Sling TV. What about like UK and other places, or would that also possibly be Sling TV?
No idea.
They said they were going to roll out for Canada, UK and Australia and New Zealand a little later. I don't know how later, and I don't know where and whom they've tied up with.
Yeah, some fingers legal crossed. Ways of watching the show is yet to be announced.
That is available, but, by the way.
I don't doubt that one bit. Of course it's available.
True measure of success.
No, people have asked this question on Twitter, like, where can we see it? I'm from New Zealand, I'm from Wellington, whatever. And the answer immediately comes is, hey, Telegram, bhai, Telegram.
Bhai, link DM karta hu.
But I love the innocence of some of the audiences, you know, the way they actually DM or message us on social media. So link bhejiye na kahin se download karke. On the first day of my film release, Gujarati film release, and they really asked for ke kahin se link bhejiye na, kahan dekh sakte.
Wow.
Aapke paas to ho gayi.
I've gotten a lot of Amazon pe aayega na.
It's a play.
It's a play, man.
No, for them it's like, you know, noodles and Maggie, the difference between noodles and Maggie. Every noodles is Maggie. So every OTT is Amazon.
I'm
just imagining you guys in the middle of your premiere, you'd be like, oh, sorry, gotta go. Rakesh ne bola link bhejna hai, to main usko copy paste.
I guess jana padega. Yeah. I'm imagining Pratik and Shreya premiere ke side pe ye VPN ko pirate pe bhejna. Chayan Divish wants to know, did you guys meet the family of the people involved in real life for your respective roles?
No, I haven't met any family member yet. I mean, none of us could meet family members.
Yeah,
yet.
Yeah, none of us.
Even we have not heard anything from them, even after the release of the show.
Right.
But I did meet a lot of people who used to work closely with Harshad Mehta.
Okay.
Yeah, when we were actually, you know, trying to learn a lot of things about him as a person, his personality, his characteristics, the way he used to talk, and a lot of things.
And what were the key things you took away from them?
So he said that he was very flamboyant. He was a very fun-loving person. I mean, he had no habits as such, never had bad habits. Like, he never used to smoke or drink or nothing.
Yeah.
Very jovial. And he used to actually deliver those one-liners.
Mm.
Like a film star, you know, he believed in those one-liners.
Yeah. And he believed in that Bachchan of the market myth, right?
Yeah, like, Bachchan of the market. Guys,
by the way, did you know that Shadab Khan is the guy who plays Ajay Kedia, who's the son of Amjad Khan?
Yes.
Yes.
I found out after, when
same,
I was Googling all
same.
The people.
Found out after.
Stuff. I was like, oh, this guy, oh, from that Rani
Mukherjee. No, because Hansel keeps making that joke that they call Scam the Sholay of web series, and we got
it. Yeah, and you know what? I have to give him credit. Like, I have to give that, because you hate Ajay Kedia from the second you see him, right? He has made him, and this is full credit to the, like, to the actor. He has made him the most punchable guy, like, from minute one, right? He's just got, he makes him so punchable. It's amazing.
Hey, sorry, this is a great comment. Since you're talking about people who have worked with Harshad, some guy, Biryani Saurus in the chat says, sorry, but this is very funny. Bhushan Madarchot should be a t-shirt. And I know Bhushan Bhatt was like a fictional character,
but still. That was like pura bhadas nikal gaya us ek shot mein.
But the way Chirag has performed is, Chirag Vora the actor.
Tremendous.
Brilliant job, man.
Agreed.
Till that scene, you feel for him. That bichara, yaar, isko bola tha, partnership diya nahi. Suddenly when he flips, oh my God.
That was quite brilliant. That was quite brilliant. This thing, Mayank Huda.
I'm sorry, I'm going back to Shadab Khan. Did you know he was in Raja Ki Aayegi Barat?
Yeah, just like the Rani
Mukherjee. Really? Just said it.
He was the hero with Rani Mukherjee.
Really? Wow. No, I do not. I did not know this.
The things you learn.
Hello. Maaf kiya Ajay Kedia ko. Mayank Huda said, Shreya, I have a big, big, big crush on you. Your smile resembles my ex's so much, and I want to text her so bad. Shreya, do what you will with that information. I don't know what to do. Just do what you will with that information.
Yeah, like this and
yeah.
Should we encourage this man to make a bad decision just because it'll be funny?
Are ishq hai to risk hai, lala.
Timing.
Shreya has now two cases for cracking conspiracy in Why Cheat India and Scam. Question. Yes. It's not related to anything, but when is the second season of Family Man coming? Yes, your fate is in the balance, goddammit.
That is true.
Yeah.
That
is true. Your fate is fully in the balance.
You'll find out in the first 5 minutes of the first episode in season two.
Fantastic.
Whether Pratik, I'm alive or dead.
Dexter Tech has said, Pratik Gandhi and Shreya have set a new benchmark in this web series. I cannot imagine anyone else playing Harshad Mehta or Sucheta. This is true. You guys have definitely first to post and best to post straight up there.
But there's also a lot of credit. I want to take some time to give a lot of credit to Hansel and Jay, who fought for every single person on the cast and the crew, regardless of their experience or the baggage or the names or whatever. They have fought for all of us to be on the cast, in front of the camera, behind the scenes.
Full credit.
I hope our show has actually broken the very notion that you have to be a certain thing, or you have to do this, or the subject has to be like this, or it has to be done a certain way with certain people. I hope it shattered all of that.
I really hope so also. That definitely full credit there. Shivashish Mohanty, thank you. Top five favorite non-Indian web series of Pratik and Shreya.
Go Pratik, you first.
Okay. You guys don't have to give five. Like, it's a very demanding audience. Yeah. Just give any that you like. You don't have to give five. It's fine.
Yeah, because I haven't seen that many. Anyways. Money Heist. Succession. Breaking Bad. And ek dusra jo dekha tha. Teen chalega na, teen.
Teen chalega, haan, zarur chalega. Shreya.
Over to you, Shreya. Watchmen. Give us eight.
Watchmen.
Okay.
Westworld. Star Trek Discovery. Schitt's Creek. Ted Lasso. Actually, I can keep going. Lovecraft Country.
Keep going.
Yeah, there's a bunch of Are you watching the latest season of Star Trek?
I have given up on Discovery. I have thoughts. My thoughts on Discovery I detest Discovery. It is a blot. Discovery. It is a blot on all things Star Trek. But it's a separate conversation for a separate day. We have other people here with us.
I love
Discovery.
Ted Lasso is on Apple TV, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
And Pirate Bay. Sushant Kumar has said, have you guys already talked about Ravan Leela? No, we have not yet talked about Ravan Leela. What should we? Pratik.
So Ravan Leela is a film that I had shot before Scam, and okay. it is going to release now in December sometime.
Okay.
Which I guess in next few days we should come out with the teaser and the release date also.
Oh, fantastic!
These guys are planning the theater release. So yes,
yay!
My first theater release after a long
also,
time.
Also, I think Prateek and his wife, the wonderful Bhamini, are starring in a short film called Spam.
Spam, जो हमने बहुत पहले किया था, दो तीन साल पहले किया था.
Which is releasing soon, ना?
So, हुआ क्या है ना, स्कैम के बाद बहुत सारी जगह से मेरी सारी नई पुरानी चीजों को कहीं ना कहीं कुछ कुछ प्लेटफॉर्म मिल रहे हैं. So good.
Yeah.
So I'm more excited. Congratulations. I'm so happy to hear that.
That's right.
So I'm really excited to go on stage and perform one of my plays, because पहले जो ऑडियंस को घर जाके लाना पड़ता था, अब वो खुद आ जाएंगे.
That's very exciting. I think that's very very exciting that you can use this to leverage that and to draw people into the theater. I think that's tremendously cool. M12 has said PV Narasimhanao ka naam nahi lena chahiye tha, censor bolega. Darshan Singh V has sent a chat saying, please do price action based investment. PA shows early on what's cooking and help save investors money from Yes Bank and Lakshmi Vilas stocks. Well, congratulations viewers. Now you know. Now you know. You have been this thing. Mansanjam Singh Bhatia said, I absolutely loved Scam. It was a legit binge-worthy show. Prateek sir and Shreya ma'am are hot. Any opinions on Jamtara and any recommendations? My opinion on Jamtara, that's very nice. My recommendations are, eat green vegetables, you will poop better. He didn't say recommendation about what?
Fair exploitation of the loophole, Mr. Joshi.
I think so. I think it's a crack-a-lacking exploitation of very the loophole. Not going to answer this. When is Family Man Season 2 coming out? It will come out when it comes out. More questions. How long? Sameer Kulkarni wants to know, how much time did it take to shoot the entire series, including auditions, table reads, etc. Love the series. Great job.
So I guess we started talking about this series in 2018.
Oh, wow. Okay.
So I guess June 2018 is when I met Hansel sir for the first time.
Yeah.
Right.
And then it took a long, long time. So around
March, September 2019, when I came on board, I was the last cast member to come on board.
Right.
So March 2019, and we wrapped earlier this year.
Okay.
5th March was the last shoot day.
Yeah.
5th March 2019.
Oh, you just made it in. Like you just made it in under like the lockdown deadline.
Just in time.
Yeah.
Oof. Vaibhav wants to know, how do you think Beyar affected your career? Beyar was a landmark Gujarati film, right? For people you might know, it was a landmark Gujarati film. So Prateek, how did what did that do to your career?
So that did a lot of things. It changed a lot of things for all the people who were involved in the film.
Right
from the writer, director, actors, everybody I guess. For me particularly, so that was my first film that I did along with the job. Full-fledged job से 20 दिन की छुट्टी लेके जाके शूट किया था और फिर आके वापस नौकरी चालू कर दिया था. When it was released, I could not even go for the promotion and I did not know what actually has happened in Gujarat. Because that film came in Bombay. It was released in Bombay after a long time, you know, once it was released in Gujarat. क्योंकि बॉम्बे में उतने थिएटर मिल नहीं रहे थे. And then when it got released, they actually had to release in Bombay 7 times.
Oh, wow.
On public demands. Every new film came, they used to take it out, and suddenly by the public demand, they used to again release it.
That's so
good.
It happened
seven times in Bombay.
Oh, I didn't know
in
that.
In one of the theaters on Malad SV Road, it happened 7 times. And then it became such a big thing that I started getting a lot of offers, but because of the full-time job, I could not take all the films. So I had to wait for 2 more years for Wrong Side Raju to come.
Yes, which was 2016. Right.
And then finally, I quit my job and became a full-time actor. So yeah, somewhere, I guess, Bayar, did that seeding in my mind that now things are going to change. I better be ready.
That's incredible. And I'm very, very thankful that seeding happened and that we got the performances that we've gotten from you. Arjun Garba, thank you for super chat. This is Prateek. He says, from Tino of Bayar, investing in Labuma to Harshad Bhai ruling the BSC. You have given us moments to cherish. Thank you, Prateek Bhai.
Oh my god, that anecdote from the film, man.
That, yeah, full on. Ankita Kulkarni has a cool question. What's a role in Hindi cinema that both of you would have loved to play, and you guys have killed it in Scam, is the side on to that thing. What's a role, like a role that's already done that you would have loved to play?
I don't want to touch things that have already been done. I'm always like, it's nicer to play the thing that you're supposed to, meant to play. You know, I don't want
these cool answers. I would like sentimental answers, if that's okay.
I swear, I don't want to touch. For example, I love Sridevi. Why the hell would I touch that perfection? No.
Fair.
So, मुझे जो एक्चुअली सदमा में श्रीदेवी ने जो किया था वही परफॉर्म करने की इच्छा होती है. दिस इज समथिंग दैट आई वांट टू यू नो चैलेंज मायसेल्फ विद, कि ये करते हैं यार.
ब्रिलियंट, दैट्स अ गुड.
पर अगर वो मतलब मेल कैरेक्टर होता तो बहुत मजा आता यार मुझे तो करने.
इंटरेस्टिंग इन्वर्जन, माइट बी फन.
आई फील दैट अबाउट एवरी मेल पार्ट रिटन.
Oh my god.
Moving on very swiftly.
Shreya went from being all prim and proper diplomatic answer to fuck yeah.
Yeah, just like boss abhi. Boss abhi.
Mujhe harshat karna tha bole.
Next time Pratik, you play a guy called Suchit Dalal, I'll play Harshada Mehta.
Yeah, why doesn't Kiran Mazumdar show to fraud?
Coming soon, Shreya Dhanvantari in and as the Chanda Kochar story. Harnaspreet Singh, thank you for your super chat. This is the first ever web series that my family has watched together, and there's still a discussion in one of the episodes, and from knowing him as a scamster, everybody feels sympathetic from him now. Great job, guys. I have no idea if that great job, guys, is sarcastic or not. but that is it true that Pranav Sheth was actually Ketan Parikh's character?
No, not at all.
Not at all,
from
exactly.
Which angle did you feel that?
Exactly. No.
Because based on the Twitter threads. So, this Joshi, I don't know if you guys saw, but like after, just as soon as it came out, there are like these Twitter threads on, and even on Reddit, people are speculating as to who's who. There are articles. So many of those articles say it's Ketan Parikh. That's why I think this person's asking.
Ah, okay.
So the Madhu Mundra and all of those people were accurate. Apparently.
I thought Pranav Sheth was Junjunwala, but never mind.
No, that's the other guy.
Never mind.
Who was with the... Yeah, you can't say all of that.
Never mind.
Guessing, guys.
I didn't say which Junjunwala. I met my friend Amar Junjunwala from the 6th floor. देखो मैं सिगरेट नहीं पीता पर जेब में लाइटर जरूर रखता हूँ धमाका करने के लिए इज प्रॉब्ली द बेस्ट डायलॉग एवर मच लव थैंक यू अक्षय मेहता फॉर सेइंग दैट
यू
द टू बेस्ट थिंग्स दैट हैपेंड इन 2020 सेज डेक्सटर टेक वाज स्कैम 1992 एंड मैक्सिमस स्टुपिडस जस्ट वांट टू टेक दिस ऑपर्चुनिटी टू थैंक आशीष दैट्स राइट आशीष हैज अ न्यू ह्यूमन न्यूज़लेटर आउट दैट इज डूइंग वेरी वेल
टू काइंड एंड व्हाट इज दैट कंपैरिजन ओह माय गॉड क्या बट ठीक है नाइस थैंक यू
इट्स सो नाइस
यार
वी आर सब्सक्राइब
Shashank Hegde says, love from Germany. It's sad that I can't watch Scam 1992 over here. Sony, not cool. Anyway, congratulations, guys. FOMO kicking in really well. Lol. Shashank, the internet is a wide and wonderful place, is all I will say.
okay.
Vishwas Arora, absolutely love you too in the series. Can't get over such amazing work done and views about the movie The Big Bull. Abhishek Bachchan has started. I think two different products. Let's not compare apples and oranges. Harnaspreet Singh has qualified that the great job was appreciating only, not sarcastic. All right, let's do more questions for you guys.
People are like, Sanju was scammed 2018.
What about, actually this is interesting, Ritik Sharma wants to know a word about Rajat's acting. What I personally loved about Rajat's character is he comes in like a hand grenade, right? Things are happening, and suddenly, pfft. What was that energy like? Because he's, and this is not what you expect
he's
from Rajat Kapoor.
He's too good, man. Too good. I keep saying that he actually, you know, flows on set like water. You don't right. even feel he's acting. He's Ooh. So effortless. Achha, he doesn't go anything beyond the script, okay? Whatever lines or dialogues that he's saying, he doesn't change it much. But each and every line actually comes to you as if he is just saying it right now.
Oh.
Yeah.
And he's so real.
Gave me chills.
Yeah. I straight had this moment. Like, Mahesh uncle, I don't want to meet you in a dark alley. Never again. Like, aap Australia se wapas aake kaafi badal gaye ho, Mahesh uncle.
Dude, in India, you're afraid of the cops. But the first time, I'm like, oh, okay, get it. He's fine.
Ab samjha CBI kya hota hai. Like, it's very that. Directors, Abhijit Chugh, interesting question. Directors that you would love to work with. Hansal Mehta is a rock star and he should be here maybe in the future. I would love to interview Mr. Hansal Mehta. I think he is a rock star. But directors that you would love to work with.
Jay Mehta.
He's the co-director
of the show.
I know, you already technically worked with him.
No, but he's going to be in the future. I can't wait to... He's going to be in the future.
I think so.
Jay Mehta, right? Was Kamyab Jay Mehta?
No.
Kamyab the movie? No.
This is his first distinct project.
Oh, okay. My bad.
Too cool. Hiranye Gajbiye has come in here to say, please join our subreddit r/IndiaStreetBets to know how to lose money in the stock market. Cool. $1 trillion self-promotion. Does working on reality-based shows change your perspective of the initial event, or do you see it as just another script?
So I actually see it as a script. Because ultimately, I mean, it can't be, you know, presented to you as it is.
Right.
Otherwise, it doesn't work. Anything that you adapt from the book also, you know, it needs to be adapted for the format that you are using.
True.
If it's a script, if it's a film or a short film or a web film or a web series.
Right.
Or a teleserial, or for that matter, a play. Stop. Each and every medium is different.
True.
So that dramatization, you know, as per the medium needs to be done.
And you have to make it cinematic, right?
Yeah. And so we see everything as a script. Otherwise, things will never be communicated.
Nice. Yeah.
For me, it's both, because I feel like once you see something, you're anyway driven by curiosity to check out what the real thing was about.
Right.
So I feel like one thing feeds to the other. Like, I know all of my existing knowledge about dinosaurs from Mr. Spielberg. What do I say?
Of course. And it turns out Mr. Spielberg may have been playing fast and loose with the facts.
Right?
Yeah. Turns out the damn things had feathers, apparently.
And colors.
Yeah. I'm actually very glad that wasn't the case, because I would have had different levels of nightmares if those things had been feathered. Like that. Because on the one hand, I'm like, ye mereko kha jayega. Second hand, pe kha nahi jayega, toh mera allergies aane wala isse.
They didn't prove it yet. We still don't know.
That's true. We still don't know. Anurag Voleti wants to know, is it true that Harshad Mehta was only used as scapegoat to bring out exploitation of loopholes in the BR thing? And people were doing it since long. Abhi jaake RBI governor se puchta hu, Anurag. Abhi jaake puchta
hu. Partially.
Partially, yes.
That is true. Yeah, that is true.
He was still very much a criminal, but he was one of several.
Yeah, which doesn't make him less of a criminal. Just makes him one of the many.
Shut up, Sucheta ji. Only you got good things in your career because of this, okay? That is why you are saying. That is why you are scapegoating Harshad. Akshay Mehta has an interesting question. How does one prepare for a role? So how does one prepare for such a role? So much swag.
This Pratik will answer.
Huh.
Pratik, go for it.
You see, okay, I don't have any particular method or any particular procedure to create the character. The only thing is that so whenever I read the script, get the narration, I create that emotional arc of the character, that how his emotions are going to travel throughout the script.
Right.
And I just try to be as true as possible to that character with that emotion.
Right.
So the only thing that what I carry with me when I go on floor is that I have certain idea about the character. Ki ye banda aisa tha, aisa iska characteristics hai. Within that characteristics, I have to create each and every scene and make it live there, there itself.
Right.
So that's it. That's the only thing that I do for the characters.
Got it. Sampath GGS says, Shreya, love to see you in Tollywood movies again.
Why not? Yeah, but nobody's offering me anything. What should I do?
There we go. Chop chop. Directors who are watching, come on, get on this. So, Pratik, to just continue with what you were talking about, one of the things that was very interesting to me in your interpretation of Harshad was that you weren't going for an imitation of him in any way, right? Because like when you see the physicality and the acting of Harshad Mehta, It's poles apart. It's obviously you're going for a version where you're like, I have to be true to the emotion of this character as opposed to reel this thing off it. So what were the things that you did to sort of build that? Because there's a, you've given this character a very specific physicality of its own and all of that. So what was that process like?
So, okay. See, I have done such characters on stage for a long time.
Right.
So that helped me. Because when it comes to creating a character, no, it's, there are certain characteristics that we tend to decide in our mind that this is how he must be.
Right.
This is how he is, you know. So I have to portray his confidence. I have to portray his arrogance, his ego. He's a dreamer, an achiever, a charmer, a complete family guy. So around these characteristics, you start playing with your body language also.
Right.
So to, you know, create that arrogance and confidence, that one-sided smirk that I tried.
Right, right.
You know, which like people loved a lot, and that also connects with the character. So there are very finer changes in that smirk. Right from his initial days to his last days of complete ego and arrogance, where he's not even ready to listen to anybody, not Correct. Even to himself.
Correct.
And he's just going beyond any boundaries. So there is constant movement in the body to show the restlessness, which reflects that his mind is never at peace, never at ease.
Right.
He's constantly trying to achieve something faster than possible.
That's true. That's and
so there is a, you will see constant movement, you know, either the finger is moving or the
there's always something
moving. There's something, you know, either he's playing with his finger rings and all. These are smaller things which, you know, I mean, you don't underline it, but make it a part of your body so that when you actually see the whole thing as an audience, you might not feel there is something specifically different, but suddenly the entire character works for you.
Yeah,
that's true. That's brilliant. Shreya, same question to you. I read an interview where you said you didn't have a chance really to interact with Sujata Dalal, but you had a chance to sort of spend some time observing her.
She got a good chance with Shreya. You know what she did when she met Sujata Dalal? When we
had this is way more. It's always way more fun when another person comes. Actually, main batata hu kya hua.
Like, so go when for he it. Leans like, forward, when somebody leans forward for a story, you're like,
go for it.
So I was always under this impression that Shreya is very lucky. The character that he's going to play, she's going to play, she can meet, talk to her, understand her, and then she can create. Whereas I just have to rely on whatever the footage is available on internet and to talk to people. But when we met her, Sujata Dalal, on one of our photo shoots, Shreya was there, and I thought now she'll talk, she'll learn, she'll understand a lot of things. So Shreya was like this.
That's it. I swear.
Initially, I thought, what will we do? 2-5 minutes. And we will talk. But till the end, we were there for 4 hours. And Shreya was like...
That's true. That's very
100%
accurate. On
why? So Shreya, why? You are the last person out of anybody I've met in my life that would say that you got tongue-tied. You are the last person I would say that
I'm
about.
I'm shit scared. Yeah. I mean, this is a Padma Shri award-winning journalist. And we were halfway through the shoot. So I didn't want to kind of learn anything new that would make me regret everything that I had done till now.
Fair.
And, or otherwise, you know, because it's not exactly sequential. We're not going, you know, in sequence. And again, I mean, this is something that you do much later in your career, you know, where you're playing someone real and you're taking the responsibility of bringing them to life. And holy hell, I was like, oh my God, she's gonna hate me. So I didn't say anything. And clearly, I don't think she thought very good things because she thought it was a complete cartoon for the way I behaved. But then she liked
it. Mujhe maza ye aa raha tha ki ye ye bhi same hi ho raha hai.
Did you get a reaction from her later after the
release? Yeah, she sent a message saying that she loved the show and she thought that I did her a great service, which is like, oh my God.
So basically, tere bare mein unkind book nahi likhne wali hai wo. So theek hai. Shivashish wants to know Pratik sir's advice to people suffering from multiple passion disorder like him. Ooh. Like, I am an MBBS student but want to become an actor like him too.
They're quoting you now.
Yeah, they're full on. This is, one second, I don't think you understand how big the internet cult of Pratik Gandhi is after this show. I don't think.
Oh my god.
It has. Yeah, not occurred to you at all. Like
you're falling victim to your own line. वो क्या है वो इंडिया में क्या सबसे ज़्यादा manufacture होता है? हो रहा है अभी. हाँ. वही हो रहा है अभी.
So I guess anybody who is suffering from multiple passion disorder should explore all these things, all the passions that you have. Explore it to the core so that you never regret, that you never give it a chance. And you don't have anybody to blame.
True.
But only yourself. Yeah, but yourself. That I didn't give it a chance. मतलब फिर अकेले बैठ के कभी आराम से दो पैक पी के ये मत बोलो कि यार अपने को चांस नहीं मिला था, अपन ने फोड़ दिया होता. Because
true.
तुमको करना चाहिए था तो खुद करो. And if you had passion or if you have passion, just give it a shot.
And here now I'm going to do a little show off for Pratik. Because I've been doing some reading about you, and Pratik being very modest is because Pratik is not talking from a privileged position. Pratik has worked his ass off to pursue these passions in spite of. I know that you have worked like a 9-to-6 job and gone for rehearsal at 6 in the morning before and at 9 p.m. after and all of that. So, aisa nahi hai ki wo bol raha hai, passion explore karo with luxury of failure. Sir ne kafi ragda hai. So,
can I just add, I saw the interview of yours, I think Rohini ke saath tha. We're talking about this overnight fame, overnight success wali baat na, where you countered it by telling us your schedule beforehand. Man, that day I was like, okay, I should get out of bed and like write a little bit extra today. I feel like an asshole reading this in bed.
No, I had the opposite experience where I was reading it and I'm like, main padh ke thak gaya. मैं पढ़ के थक गया. मैं बस हो गया मेरा. बस ये पढ़ के मेरा हो गया. मतलब this is what happened. Dinesh KP says it's a shame that Shreya is not in more Tollywood mainstream lead roles. By the way, how did every actor of Scam play their role to such perfection? That's a tremendous question because every one of you is crack-a-lacking. There is not a single weak link in that cast, right?
Dude. That casting is insane. Like the people who've done the casting, I'm forgetting the name.
Mukesh Chhabra.
Yeah, man.
The team. Yeah.
No, because again, I think the right to fight for the opportunity was available to all. And the people who deserved it got it. Not because of anything else, but how good they were in the room or how good they are for the role.
Amen. So and the maker, in general, no? Yes. Yeah. Amen.
In fact, see, makers, director, Hansel sir, and the applause team, they took this quote, risk hai to iske, really too seriously.
Yeah.
And the actors, you know, for that matter. All the actors in the sense, when I'm talking about all the actors, it's like me or Shreya, that we have been doing something or the other in our own capacity. But, you know, mounting such a huge show with us is nothing less than a risk, man. Less than a risk.
Yeah, I mean,
They fought for us, by the way. Yeah? They fought for me and Pratik.
So it's not an easy thing.
That is full applause to them then, because it was definitely a fight worth having. And I think we have all been blessed by the fact that all of you were on this show for sure. The biggest compliment I can pay is that I grew up like in a Gujarati household, right? And I've said this like ever since the day I saw the show, every single person in that show looks like someone I have interacted with at a family function, right?
Yeah.
That's not just Gujju stereotypes. It's like living, breathing, crisp shirt with sleeve till here, stockbroker, Gujju bhai. And I'm like, man, I can smell it. I don't know how to say it, but like I can smell it.
It takes you to the real world.
Yeah.
So that the believability is more than 100%.
Yes.
And you see, all these actors. So I tell you, the guy who's playing Bhushan Bhatt, Chirag.
Mm.
The guy who's playing Pranav Sheth, Jai.
Mm.
The guy who played Ashwin Bhai, Hemant Kher.
Hmm.
We have been doing theater since long time together.
Okay.
And Chirag is, I guess, Chirag has been doing theater since a long, long time.
Right.
So it's for the first time that I feel all these guys got that due credit, that, you know, what they actually deserved. They got their space to perform and they performed. With all the other actors also, like Jaimini Pathak, even Anjali. Anjali has been doing only, you know, major work on this. Social media.
Yeah. Or even Brinda Trivedi.
And Brinda, yeah.
Ashwin Mehta's wife. She's an NSD graduate.
Oh,
wow.
She's an NSD graduate, yeah.
Yeah.
She recently was there in that film which won national award. Hellaro. Gujarati film that won national award.
And Faisal Rashid, who plays Debashish Basu, who's been in like so many films.
Yeah. It's just such a joy to watch like professional actors shine, man, like together in an ensemble cast. It's just such a good feeling. One quick super chat. Sorry, no, go for
sorry,
it.
Sir. No, I found an interesting question. Sameer Kulkarni has asked, and another person has asked, can we get some clarity on the intro lyrics? The internet is divided on it, is one.
Yeah, yeah, Pratik, please tell. Yeah, even I'm divided.
Gaurav Paul is like, how many of you heard Riya Meri Girlfriend in the theme song?
I think ye raaz tabhi khulega jab Achint Thakkar is chat mein aayega.
He said he'll reveal the lyrics, no? If he hits 30,000.
Yeah. Well,
now you know what to do, guys. You know, so on his YouTube channel, right? Achint Thakkar ka YouTube channel, 30,000 subscribers. Guys, you know how to unlock this mystery. You go to Achint Thakkar's YouTube channel, you subscribe, you get to 30,000 subscribers. But ideally, subscribe here first, then go to that channel. Is all I would say. Ideally.
In the meantime, we should call Jose to do a
misheard lyrics. Yeah, we should.
Call Jose.
Oh, for sure.
Sameer Tyagi has an oddly specific question. In the show, when Harshad Mehta comes face to face with Madhavan, there's a shift in his character and he loses his arrogance. Any reason for that? Maybe it's the being made to drink your own mood. Maybe. I don't know. You know?
No, but that was a very, very interesting. I mean, it's a good observation, a detailed observation that this guy had done. But that shift is for the first time Harshad actually, you know, felt that jitter and the fear that till that point he was thinking that I can manage everything,
right?
You can, I can manage anything that come my way,
right?
But here with Madhavan's entry and the way he treated him, the way he surprised him with the raid and everything, he actually got baffled,
right?
And since that point, if you see, there is a shift in the character.
Yeah, I think that's also definitively the point from which he starts losing, right?
Yes.
Like, that's the definitive point from which Harshad starts losing. Mega Kedia says, Shreya first saw you in Ladies Room and have loved you since. I'm only hoping she's talking about the web series and she's not just actually creeped on you in a random ladies room. Keep shining, says Mega. Mrugesh Patel says, Pratik sir, I met you at Ahmedabad Airport in January 2019. You were right ahead of me in queue. Till today, I regret not asking about your upcoming projects. Following you since Bayar, loved you in Scam. So, gentleman from the airport today is fulfilling his destiny of question he didn't ask you. So, thank you, Mrugesh, for that. Arnab Day has sent a super chat with very important information. He says, Achint has 36,000 subscribers now. So, excuses are over.
Oh no, his target must be 50 then.
Hey, yeah, Harshad Mehta giri ho gaya na? Aur 500, aur 500, aur 500, aur
500. Hum lekin ye kahan se layenge?
Finally, ek din CBI arrest karega, bolega, nahi, mere ko pata hi nahi lyrics ke bare mein kuch.
Hey, Sanjay ne lyrics dala hai. It is Jia mere dam pe. I don't know.
That's very good.
That sounds logical though.
That does.
I used to think Jia maine zor se. I used to think that.
That's
like a loud guy.
It's just slightly louder. Piyush Pandey, love new concert. Teri Yeh Majaal, remind me of good old Royal Torch Show. Any plan for Zoom or online show for same in the future? No, I don't know yet, actually. Not sure at this point. Let's go on to a few more questions. I also want to point out that like we have hit the 30 question mark. So if you guys have things to do with your lives, you guys are welcome to leave. I'm just going to keep asking a few more questions anyway. This is, I can't see who's asked the question because it's proof path, but I knew this was going to come. Please speak in Gujarati. That's the entire question.
Lala, ye to mari potani bhasha chhe. Mane jaraye sharam nathi, jaraye vandoy nahi.
I'm sorry, as a Gujarati, I just got turned on. Maru Gujarati ye to saras nathi, pan who turn on thai gyo.
Very nice. Bahu Mumbai walo Gujarati bolya chhe, bhai.
Ha, bahu Mumbai walo Gujarati chhe. I have been told this. Vidata Shetty says, how much of it was the VFX and how much was just sets? I'm thinking all of it was sets. Was there
all
any?
Of it was sets.
Yeah. All it's of it a real sets. Location. All yeah. Majority of the real locations that we've used.
That is fantastic.
Just for the background, because we had to clean up the wires and the beaches and stuff.
Yeah, of course. Yeah. Of course.
De-aging of Bombay.
Derek Massey says, please take my name. So everyone, please say Derek Massey.
Derek Massey.
Why no one taking other actors interview? Everywhere I go, I only see them. Because Harshad Bhai ni Rajma streams Majama.
Right. But take other actors interview. I'll fix it up for you.
I will very happily interview. I want to adopt Jay, who played Pranav Sheth. I want to adopt him. I want to keep him in my house.
Oh, yes. Wait a minute. One second.
Fun fact, by the way, he was in Family Man.
You just say this. I'll record it.
What was he in Family Man?
He was Dr. Desai.
Oh, shit, yeah.
Who got killed?
Yeah.
He dies.
So Jay, who played Pranav Sheth, I want to adopt him and I want to keep him in my house and I want to party with him and I want to chill with him because he just is too cute, man. He's just too cute.
I feel like if I meet him, he'll just try and sell me something. It just feels like
And this is a little bit Pratik's fault also because of his acting in the thing. I have a friend named Pranav who ever since the show came out, I have only called Pranav Bhai. I have only called him Pranav Bhai since the show came out. I have not called him anything else. And he gets damn irritated. Even the Diwali message I sent him was, Happy Diwali, Pranav Bhai.
That's his name now.
Yeah, that's his name. It's done. Bijui has an interesting question. How can I meet Ashwin Mehta? I really want to talk to him. Please help. So Ashwin Mehta actually is a fascinating story in and of himself. Because the bit that you guys showed in the show, that he went and he essentially taught himself the law to be able to go to court. And he actually got their name cleared in some cases and he got some cases moved along and he did that. And to me, I'm like, this is a whole separate inspirational story in its own way, right?
Yeah.
Because he tried to be a calming influence on Harshad, didn't work, absolutely participated, all of that. But then just sort of kept going. And there's
but
something
you know,
very...
Harshad Mehta actually was the oldest brother, has three other brothers.
Yes. But they were pretty much out of the this thing, right?
Yeah.
Like out of the picture.
Yeah.
Largely. Like that's kind of cool though. Pratik sir, actually for both of you, what was your first reaction when you got to know about the IMDb ratings for Scam?
We all shouted, actually. We started calling each other. Did you hear this?
That's amazing.
And then suddenly those screenshots started coming in. Then people started sharing those things.
And it's still there, It's still there.
Yeah, it's still there, man.
Yeah, that's amazing. And I'm not surprised. It's a great
show.
This
is where Indian population comes in handy.
Absolutely. Mani Tiwari says, please tell Pratik, sir, we have made a fan base of him in Indore, which has more than 70,000 members, God-level acting, sir. If there's any chance those guys want to subscribe to youtube.com/Rohan Joshi, that would be amazing. Pratik, any...
Thank you very much, yaar. Aisa matlab mujhe to pata hi nahi tha aisa kuch hai.
Are, sir, abhi to shuruaat ho rahi hai. Aditya Kompali wants to know, Pratik, any stock tips?
Kya karu Shreya, jo maine aage bola tha, bol dun kya wapas?
Yeah, do it.
Yeah, so guys, there is this interesting IPO which has just come a month back. It's called Pratik Gandhi. You can invest in me.
Done. Sold.
RO is high.
Lekin sir, ek BR dekhna padega lekin. BR actually dekhna padega.
Lala, sab mil jayega.
Ye to private show ho raha hai.
You know, fun fact, our little AIB connection to your show is Swamiji was played by Karthik, who was in a bunch of AIB videos when you started out.
I know.
I had a moment when I first saw Swamiji, I'm like, ye itna familiar kyun dikhta hai? And then moments later, I'm like, hey, ye to apna Karthik hai, yaar.
Arre, apna wo BJP versus Congress mein tha, sabse pehle.
Haan, arre, Diwali mein tha, BJP Congress mein tha. Pritesh Mistry asking the important question. Since Scam 1992 web series started, why ACC Cement stock is up? I don't know, man.
It does, yeah.
Yeah. Shreya Saran actually has interesting question. What are two things that each of you learned from Harshad Mehta's story? One bad thing and one good thing.
Come on, Shreya.
Okay. I can answer in cliches.
Go for
one good thing that I've learned is or a factual thing, is that pride always goes before a fall. And one other thing that I've learned is keep your friends close, but enemies closer.
Oh, ho, ho. Oh, ho.
I'm not sure which one is good and which one is bad, but I've learned these two
things. Fair.
From Harshad Mehta.
Yeah.
Okay. So one good thing that I have learned from Harshad Mehta is don't be afraid of, achieving bigger things.
That's true.
And
fair.
Getting into those circles.
Then they're lying, na, Pratik. Zindagi ka sabse bada jokhim na lene mein.
Na lene mein hai.
Beautiful.
Ka sabse bada jokhim to jokhim na lene mein.
That's beautiful.
So guys, fail early, fail fast is the philosophy is what
correct,
I learned.
Correct.
That's tremendously good advice.
Yes.
The one bad thing which I learned is that in the journey of achieving your dream, be conscious that when you suddenly become slave of your dream and you don't even know when the dream, becomes greed and you are still serving that greed.
Those are wise and sobering words. Those are very yeah. And can apply in so many situations.
Yeah, man.
Tirth Trivedi, thank you for your super chat. So this super chat is only for Pratik Bhai for the monologue performed in Saurabh's show.
Whoa.
Rohan, what webcam are you using? Har bar ye question aata. It's the Sony ZV-1, guys. Ganesh S, out of web series, are you invested in stock market? At this point, everyone has answered no already. So we're not going to this thing. This is an interesting question. You had to put on weight for the part and then drop it again. What was that Christian Bale like experience like?
Oh, that's a very, very interesting experience to which Rhea never agreed that I put on weight.
He didn't.
I mean,
I'm like, where?
No. There's a point at which you can see the most method acting of the whole series and all the amazing acting Pratik has done. The most method acting is there's a very specific Gujarati paunch that men over a certain age in Gujarat get, which he displayed with great flair once Harshad reached a certain age.
That's what we're saying. It should have been like much bigger, but even though he put on 18 kilos, you couldn't see, man. The man is so fit. The fat refused to show. They're like, nah, we're not coming
out. I'm jealous for this. It's not on you.
That's fair.
No, it was a very deadly experience. Tha, yaar, ye, aisa, pura wazan badhao.
Yeah, he was
body kahin par bhi kaise
badhega.
He's like, nahi khana hai.
Nahi khana yaar. Aur fir lockdown hua. Bhagwan ne chaha ke beta jo tune kiya tha na sab nikal. So lockdown ke pehle 60 din pehle main mota tha. Fir lockdown hua. Ab main fit ho gaya. Waisa ho gaya
scene. Also his family, they are COVID survivors.
Really?
Yeah, man.
Oh man, I'm so everybody. I hope everybody's safe and well. And I'm
touch wood.
Everybody's
good, man.
Touch wood. That is amazing. Rona wants to know, have you all read the novel? Also, Why So Cutie Shreya? I mean, novel matlab book. I have read the book, but my biggest problem I had with the book is I did not feel it was as narratively well arranged as the show was.
It's more fact based, na?
Yeah,
like,
it is, and it was a tough read. Like it was a tough read.
It's a tough read. Yeah.
Dexatech, did you get a chance to interact with anyone from Harshad Mehta's family during the web series after Get Over? No, they have already answered that. SBI officials are so obsessed with scam 1992 that if you go to SBI to open account, instead of PAN card, they ask for BR and SGL. Darshan Singhvi has a question and a request. Question is, and school question. How different was Diwali 2020 versus Diwali 2019 for the two of you?
Diwali 2019 is when we actually took a break between during our shoot.
Right.
So that was the time where we were, very, very excited that we are on something really, really interesting. And we were actually waiting for the next schedule to start to finish this. And now this Diwali, I guess we have seen what we have seen.
Absolutely.
Itna bada bomb phata hai bahar sab jagah.
Aha.
Aapko pata nahi itna bada fraud hua hai sir.
Yeah, that's love. So hum log sab roz
Harshad.
Shreya, when what I was damn surprised was that when Mr. Bilari walked into your office, your first dialogue should have been, "Are tu yahan pe bhi?"
Yeah.
That
Would that was been... my audition scene, by the way, that opening scene.
Oh, really?
That was a great scene. Yeah,
that's a very good scene.
That page is long. Yeah.
Oh, that's... Because when he says, Suchita ma'am ke paas bhejo, I was like, oh, ho, ho, maza aane wala. Because I've only heard the name. I didn't like realize it was based on the book and also, like, I went in completely cold.
I also really like that little, like, magic realism element of having R.K. Lakshman there.
Yeah,
it gives it a really nice fairy tale-ish element all of a sudden, which I thought was such a beautiful touch right at the start, right? I thought that was really, really cool. Varun Sharma wants to know, Harshad Bhai, Malia, Nirav Modi or Subrat Roy, who is your favorite scammer? हाँ पता है सबने देखा है वो Netflix वाला शो ठीक है सबने देखा है but
favorite scammer कैसे हो सकता है
I don't have an answer you can answer this Prateek
I also don't have an answer I mean who's your favorite scammer I mean
who's your favorite villain it's just I think Mugambo. For me
we can I'm have gonna... answers for that though who's your favorite cinema villain
I mean, sure. But if I have to answer out of the four of these people, I have to say Subrata Roy because he is the closest out of all of them I've seen to being a real life James Bond villain. Right? Whoa. Like, I am convinced that that Sahara Ambi Valley city is hiding like a nuclear missile silo. Like, this is, I'm convinced of this. And no one can take this away from me, this thought. Like, one day I will be proven right, and by that time it'll be too late, guys. Shreya says with the important question, how was the Lexus car experience?
Okay. So, usme AC nahi chalta tha. During the shoot, it was very difficult for me.
Oh, shit.
Because it was refurbished Lexus that we got from somewhere to, for the shoot. Okay. Because that was the only piece available of that time.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, they offered me ke shoot ke baad tum le jana, and I said no. I am happy with my Wagoner.
Usme AC chalta hai. Usme AC sahi chalta
hai. Haan yaar.
Aur kya chahiye?
We already answered this, Vignesh, about stocks basics in stock finance. Yes, they had to learn very very quickly. When we binge watch a show, we subconsciously adapt the character's quirks and style, asks Divya Shri. So how long were you guys hungover in these characters after you were done performing them?
Well, I was shooting three shows simultaneously with Scam. I couldn't afford to do that.
Okay, fair.
Okay.
Yeah, so I mean, the moment you are out of the set, you are yourself. It's like the moment you wear the costume, you are a character. That's how I take it.
And plus, we were very, like, all of us were sort of, like, switch-on, switch-off, impulsive actors. Mm. Like, even the way we work was sort of very in sync, you know?
Right.
Yeah.
So, this one thing that you should know about Shreya. When the clap is here, clap is here.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, shit. I knew you would tell the story.
Yeah, shot 9, take 1. The clap is here and if she's talking something, unless she finishes the topic, she will not stop.
I believe that. You know what? I would believe that. I have no trouble believing that.
And she said, you know, then what happened in the night? I told her, the clap is here.
But then
he
drops that in character, huh?
Kaun hai ye director jo beech mein aa raha
hai? And the moment it says action, she switches like anything. And suddenly you're still taking that breath. Abhi to wo baat chal rahi thi na yaar.
That is
that's true. Prateek and Faisal used to complain. Yaar, please, yaar, tell her not like to stay in character.
Faisal used to complain. I heard that. Mujhe to bahut maza aata tha ki ye kya hai.
Yeah, Faisal. Yeah. Please, yaar, please. I need 5 minutes. I can't do this.
This Shreya girl, very disruptive in class, huh? Nishit Parwani, who is Bhushan inspired from? They're not telling us who's based on who. We have to get who.
So it's an amalgamation of lot of the characters.
Yeah, the guy who plays my source, DT,
right?
He's also an amalgamation of a lot of people and the sources that she had.
Okay. There we go. Yeah.
I usko bhi Google kar raha tha, wo nahi mila
mujhe.
What I like is that Nishit Parwani expects to get some very important answers in the middle of this stream. Yeah. Who sold the 16 lakh shares? Nishit is like, who sold
people.
The 16 lakh shares? Subrata Roy. Subrata Roy sold the 16 lakh. Yes. Sure. All right, let's do last few questions. And then we can let you guys go and get on with your lives. Abdali has an important question, which is, How have your lives changed after the show has come out?
Pratik's life has changed.
Why do you say so? Okay.
No, because I already answered the in the start of the show.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, so my life has changed a lot. Before this scam, Rohan never knew me. He never called me for the show. This is the first time that I'm called on his show, which is a big, big thing for me. So thank you, Rohan, for this.
In my defense, the show didn't exist.
Just an audience.
The show didn't exist. This show didn't exist. This show
but
came
Pratik
after
scam. Pratik existed, Rohan. Pratik
did. Pratik
existed. I was there. Aapki nazar nahi gayi hogi.
Sir, sir, remember, sir, it always takes the longest to find the biggest and best diamond. Because, right? Like, look, don't analyze it. Just go with the sentiment.
Oh, okay, yeah, you're right.
Just go with the sentiment. Right? Gujarati kahavat from Pratik, that's already done. This is something that a lot of people have been asking for. Please do the smirk. Take my 500 crores, Pratik. Take it. Aru, thank you for your 100 rupees, but I'm not asking Shreya that. Yo Bro says, please ask Shreya, how does it feel to be the new national crush?
Am I?
Well, you know
people
now.
Don't hate me.
You heard it here first. See, just don't go to the comment section of real Harshad Mehta interviews. Just if you avoid those, you're fine.
Basically. National crush sounds like there's going to be a ceremony at like the parliament or whatever. Where
President will give an honorary like star.
Rashtriya crush.
Rashtriya crush.
Rashtriya.
I like that.
Para Rashtriya Pakshi kaun hai? More. Rashtriya crush kaun hai?
Harsha, you might have missed this. When Pratik sir's new movie is releasing with his life partner Bhavan Yodha, we are very excited. You said soon, right?
Yeah. That so we are yet to shoot that. It's okay. Just announced that we'll be shooting something together soon.
Okay.
So yeah.
Fingers crossed and good luck to all of that. All right, last few questions. Which I will ask. And find a good one. Sure. Nice. Tada, must, must. Please ask Shreya about Ladies Room and that experience. Big fan of that series. My second super chat because you didn't see the first one I did. Sorry. Yep. Ladies Room experience. Definitely the show.
Yeah. No, it was. Back when there weren't any OTT platforms, so it was a Yash Raj web series and came on YouTube. I was with the wonderful Sabah Azad. And each episode was like 20 minutes based inside a different ladies' room, inside a different loo,
right,
where our characters get into different sorts of trouble and crap, figuratively and literally speaking. And we shot 6 episodes in 6 days, 20 minutes episodes. Yeah.
Oh, wow.
That's pretty cool. Yeah.
That's very cool. Gajanan Baheti wants to know, was the word Lala something that Harshad Mehta said, or was that something Pratik that you just added in there?
No, so I guess it was written by the writer and we decided to use it at an appropriate space that goes with the meter of the dialogue, and that's how I have used it.
Right.
But recently somebody told me that Harshad Mehta also used to use this word Lala. I never knew it before that we shot. Yeah.
That's amazing. That's very, very cool. That's amazing. Thank you, Gurjeet Singh, for your super chat. Last question to both of you before I let you go. I could honestly keep going forever. What fun plans now for the next few months / years? What fun things with, like, and I mean, aside from Shreya, we pray that your plumber comes. But aside from that,
hopefully we will have more opportunities, yeah, because that's all we really want. Everything else is pretty much bonus, you know?
Absolutely.
So hopefully we just get that. We hopefully will have chances to come on live streams where people talk about how we've entertained them successfully and happily and so on and so forth. But yeah, hope that we just get opportunities. So just,
yeah, excited to create more interesting characters.
I think so, and like, I think from
very
everybody.
Honest little bacha type replies. These are very honest.
But these are. I mean, I can feel the genuine earnestness coming through, and having watched this show and having watched both of you and the entire cast, like you use the word entertain, but it's so much more than that. What you guys have done with that show. So I wish you all the best with all these many, many opportunities, and I hope only amazing things happen for both of you. Thank you so much for your time. Thank you to single person that has written in today. I wish we could take more questions, but we've been going for a while. Thank you, fans. It's been a pleasure. And thank you, everybody who's watching. And that's about it.
Thank you, Rohan. Thank you, Ash. Thank you, everybody else who's watching.
Good night.
Thank you, Janta.